Hey guys, welcome back to Let's Play Red Dead Redemption Undead Nightmare. In the last episode, we did some graveyard cleansing for good old Seth, and we found out practically nothing, except for the fact that whatever is causing all this undead shenanigans, it started back down in Mexico. So that's all we got out of that. Today's episode, what I'm going to be doing is we're going to be going over to all the way down here to Fort Mercer and see if we can find Mr. old Nigel West Dickens. So we're gonna go down there and figure out what's going on with that. But anyways, we kind of started here in Bonnie McFarlane's ranch here. Uh-oh, we got another zombie here.
They're gonna kill me. Don't you freaks ever get full.
I was gonna kill that guy. There we go. Stupid zombie.
Gotta stick together if we're gonna survive this thing.
Okay, what are you gonna give me? Revolver ammo 6. Okay, there we go. So we got 6 revolver rounds. I know it's like seems like it, when they give you ammo, it's just like a really big pitiful amount, but you know, that's the real life for you. You gotta stock up on goods and everything. I think I mentioned before in the last episode, but this horse right here, War, is actually, it has like infinite ammo, or not infinite ammo, a horse doesn't have ammo, infinite stamina, so you can keep tapping X and the horse won't get tired and everything. I always do like that about the horse, the horses of the apocalypse, because they're actually like really useful horses and it's really convenient for, you know, just running around and stuff like that. Also, I kind of want to show this off, because, well, we got a long ways to go, and I probably should be using this a lot more. I always had a bad habit when I played Red Dead Redemption. I never use this. Probably should. If you push select, and you go over to kit, I do believe you have it. Oh, no, go to... I guess we don't have that. Do we? I could have swore we had that. Never mind. I'm sorry. We don't have that in Red Dead Redemption Undead Nightmare. We have that in the regular Red Dead Redemption. You have an improvised, like, oh looky, a new animal. It's a bull. There's an undead bull. And he kind of just died. But, undead bulls actually do charge at you and they do, you know, knock you down. And, well, they're mean. They're not nice. They're, you would think, well then again, they're zombies. Like, zombie everything would try to kill you if you really think about it, but except zombie horses for some reason. Zombie horses don't do that. But anyways, back to what I was saying is, the item I was looking for was a campsite, and come help you. What's wrong, lady? I think she's gonna turn into a zombie again. This lady has always got this problem.
Only thing that's gonna cure is a bullet to the head.
Sorry, lady. Ow, if I could get him off. But, you know, even though we have this, you know, horse and everything, the zombies will still, you know, knock you off the horse. Keep that in mind. I will tell you, though, one thing about the horses of the apocalypse that I really like, They do protect you from animal attacks. So, like, if you are being attacked by a cougar, or not, no, I'm sorry, I'm thinking of another horse. There's a certain horse of the apocalypse horses that can't die. And when you're on it, you're practically invincible, except for when zombies, you know, knock you off the horse. Then you're vulnerable. But there's an apocalypse horse that has infinite health, and it cannot die. So if a let's say a bear attacks it, attacks you while you're on the horse, you are practically invincible to that bear. So it becomes a lot easier, and I'm gonna tell you right now, there's a challenge where you have to light a couple enemies on fire, kill them with a torch, and that gets really rather annoying. And I'll put it this way, having that horse of the apocalypse saves you so much trouble because of that. Now, this the kind of thing always bothers me. This guy is a cannibal. Look at him. Even though he's got a camp right here, I think I've already shown this off. You can actually set this guy's camp. Like just sit here with him. Starting to sag a little. Sweetie, stay strong. This guy is sick. Look at him. Isn't that sick? He's freaking eating people. He's got heads on here right now and everything. You know what? I really don't like cannibals. I really do not like cannibals. And that kind of just is disgusting. He just sat there and was eating people.
Don't blame me.
Ugh.
Blame the undead.
Honestly, I know the zombie apocalypse, you know, does weird things to people, but eh, it's whatever. I did get a survivalist map, and we're actually probably going to be needing that for this upcoming mission we're coming up to. I think I rambled on way too long, but anyways, there's a horse here that has infinite ammo, or infinite health, and it really does help with certain challenges, especially whenever you're trying to kill things with a torch. Because killing things with a torch is just like killing things with a knife. It's not as easy as you think it is. So, it comes in handy a lot. But, anyways, I think we're riding up here. We gotta go to Fort Mercer right here. And we notice that it's actually a safe zone. I mentioned this in about two episodes ago. This place is a safe zone. And you'll actually kind of understand why if we come up to Fort Mercer. We come up here.
Somebody's out there. He ain't one of them. Open the gate.
Howdy, mister.
Howdy. You're gonna be okay.
Step right up. Step right up. Don't be shy now. Don't be shy. Nature confounds us, but science saves us. That's the truth, sir. That's the truth. West Dickens patented tonic. The only 100% original, 200% guaranteed cure against the undead stalking this earth. It not only brings health and fitness to the sick and needy, it repels the undead and saves souls. Why, it's a natural miracle, and it's available now, here, at the low, low price of only 100 solid gold coins. That sounds expensive, but what price, eternal damnation? You, sir, you look healthy. Would you like to give it a try?
Me, sir?
Yes, sir. Would you care to demonstrate the undead defeating possibilities of this patented elixir?
No, sir, I would not. What I would like is for you to stop peddling this nonsense right now. 100 gold coins?
Well, what price would you pay for survival?
You tell me, Mr. West Dickens. You tell me.
Well, since you put it that way, why don't all you chaps all take one for free now? And if you like it, when you like it, you'll know where to find me. You won't find any undead around me. Take it, enjoy. Thanks a lot, John.
These people have lost their families. They've lost everything.
Well, that's not my fault. I'm just trying to make an honest living here.
No, you're not.
Well, okay. But can I help it if demand is high?
High?
I'm offering the people hope, John. That's a precious commodity. The tonic really works. These poor, awful, undead creatures can't stand it. Come here. Take a look.
Works like a charm.
Well, it wasn't quite what I expected.
Stuff is like catnip to those bastards.
Well, I need more desert sage and violet snowdrop, and then I know I can cure this foul plague.
Okay, back to doing your dirty work, am I?
Now, don't be like that. Don't you remember the good times? Please? I'm an old man. All right. Here. Take it. Maybe you can use it to attract some of them.
Okay. I'll see what I can do. And thanks. I'm sure this will come in real handy in case I want to meet some new and interesting friends.
Interesting.
Okay, so now we need to find 5 Desert Sage in Gatu Bridge, 5 Violet Snowdrops in, you know, West Elizabeth. But Nigel West Dickens has given us a weapon called Undead Bait. If you come up here, it's in your same slot as your, you know, your tomahawks, your fire bottles, and your dynamite. All your throwable items. Undead Bait kind of works like... the best way I can describe it is Boomer Bile from Left 4 Dead 2. What it does is, if you throw it, the zombies will become attracted to it, and it'll go to that spot. They'll just mitigate there. So you can use stuff like dynamite and stuff like that, and it'll just get a cluster mug of enemies right there. But Fort Mercer is a safe zone. It is a safe zone, and you can always be protected here. But they also are home to certain missions. And we'll get into more of that later. If we come up here to the front, you can actually kind of use this as like a safe zone if you really need to. But if you're trying to leave Fort Mercer, you'll notice that there's actually another side mission that you can actually do here. But I'm not going to do it for right now because, well, I'm going to save that for a whole entire episode because it has a different, another gameplay mechanic that we're going to be seeing pretty much quite frequently here. But we're going to come back to Fort Mercer eventually. First off, we just need to find Desert Sage and Violet Snowdrop. I think that's what it is. Journal, if we come up here. Yeah, right here. Cure for what most ails you. We need to find 5 Violet Snowdrops and 5 Desert Sage. You can find 5 Desert Sages in Gaptooth Ridge and look for Violet Snowdrop hold on a second. If I can. Yeah, there we go. Okay, look for Violet Snowdrop in the northern part of Tall Trees. We gotta go to West Elizabeth to find the Violet Snowdrop. So, for right now, let's go to Gaptooth Breach, which is over here. So let's go do that. I'm gonna go ahead and cut until we get over to this area. Then I'm gonna go ahead and show you guys a trick that, if you played Red Dead Redemption, you know what trick I'm talking about. About how to find flowers and stuff like that very easily. We actually got the item that we need in this episode too, which I thought was quite convenient. But anyways, I'll see you guys when we get to Gaptooth. Okay guys, we're here in Gaptooth Ridge here. In this area, we need to find Desert Sage. So we're kinda right here in this area, right? Okay, well we need to start looking for plants. And we've got a cougar over there. I'm gonna go ahead and kill it real quick before it gives me any trouble. That thing, I just literally just saw that thing just spawn. There we go, now it's dead. Let's actually go and search its body real quick. Undead cougar. You undead. I hate the living version of you. There's another one. Oh my gosh. Holy crap, that was a good shot. I literally see these things spawn. It's just, that's so funny. Anyways, now that we've got these guys out of the way, I hate cougars with burning passion. If you push select, and you have an item called a survivalist map, if you go ahead and use it, what it does is it allows you to see all the plants in an area. It allows you to see all wild plants near you for 20 minutes. So instead of going up to a plant and actually, or going around looking for plants, just the old flat fashion way. I think these are wild feather foo. I don't need these. But you can actually see them a lot farther away distance wise. and not, you know, until you get really super close to it. That's the problem with these plants is unless you have a survivalist map, the only way you could find them is if you got really close to them. They're indicated by these, you know, plant icons on your compass here. So let's go ahead and see what we've got right here. I've got another cougar coming up here. Desert Sage. Let's go grab that. Now, we need to collect 4 more of these. I heard another freaking cougar. But, I think what I'm going to do, that's kind of what I wanted to show you. And a Desert Sage is nothing more than just a, you know, purple plant. Desert Sage is purple. And we've got another Desert Sage right here. No, that's Wild Feather Fu. Gosh dang it. Wild Feather Fu is, you know, the flower batch right there. I think this is Desert Sage right here. Yep, Desert Sage. So we need 3 more now. Okay. And I think we found that one already. I keep hearing, I don't know if it's my mind playing tricks on me, but I keep hearing the cougar roar. You know, it's like, wow, like a cat. Okay, right here, Desert Sage.
Might as well.
Well, I need 2 more of these. Alright, so if we keep trying to find these things. See, this is what happens. The survivalist map is actually really helpful in this kind of situation. Now, flowers actually kind of are in, like, areas, you know, in certain regions of the game. Like, Gaptooth Reach has a lot of, you know, Wild Feather Flu and Desert Sage. Wild Feather Few are kind of, like, all around Hennigan's Steed and all this other stuff. But, you know, like, there's certain plants there. Like, I know there's prickly pears in Mexico, in the northern part, in the lower part of Mexico near Escalera and all that other stuff. But it's like, especially since I had to do the ambient challenges in the original game, you kind of remember where most of these flowers kind of, like, originate after you play it after a while. And, like, it's kind of sad when you really think about it. I guess it really isn't that sad. It's just, you know, in a sense, a lot of people think this is useless information to know. But if you're trying to 100% the game like I do a lot of the times when I'm playing this game, it really does not help a lot. Just, you know, or just, it really is helpful that you know all this stuff. There's a cougar. Go ahead, kill it before it kills me. Stupid cat. Let me get my last, Feather Few over here, not Feather Few, Desert Sage. There we go.
Perfect.
There we go. We've gotten all the Desert Sage that we need for Nigel West Dickens. Now we need to get 4 Violet Snowdrops and Tall Trees. So, if we look at our map here, we gotta go and make quite a trip over here. We gotta go all the way over here. So, that's going to be quite a ride. I think I'm going to go ahead and just see you guys when we get to Tall Trees.
Hey buddy, you want to help out? I bet you spare me this, I can kill all these bastards than you.
Sure. Let's go ahead and do this. This is a challenge. This is something that normally, when you do the stranger request, you'll be able to do. If he'll bet ammunition, he can, you know, kill more zombies than you. He makes this a game, essentially. Kind of, you can wager up your ammunition, get double the amount of ammunition if you go ahead and just, you know, take him on his off. Well, you can also use Deadeye. That actually does help a lot of the situation here. Boom. I'm actually kind of, like, doing such a good job killing these things. So, I got 40 ammunition for rifle because of that.
Not such a hot shot.
Well, you know, you shouldn't bet ammunition like that. Anyways, that's another thing you can do, and it's kind of fun. You can get really good ammunition out of it, because it's really not hard killing zombies. You know, especially when you have Deadeye, you kind of got an advantage because he doesn't have Deadeye. But anyways, I kind of wanted to show that off, what that is. But anyways, guys, I'm gonna meet you guys all the way over in Tall Trees. Alright, guys, we're in tall trees. I already took the liberty of fast traveling. I failed to mention that when I said 20 minutes in on the survivalist map, you have like 20 minutes to, you know, get all the stuff you need. Let me see if this is Violet Snowdrop. No, that's Hummingbird Sage. Okay. I didn't mean like 20 minutes in game time. What? What you want?
Damn, zombie's got my brother. You gotta save him.
Okay, well, where's your brother at? Let's go and see where his brother's at. This is another thing that you can do. You can, this guy will ride up and he says, "You gotta help my brother." And then you gotta go and save him.
He's trapped.
Oh, he's up here at Tanner's Reach. Okay. Okay, let's go kill these zombies. But what I was saying is, I know I said that you had 20 minutes. I didn't mean 20 minutes in game time. I meant 20 minutes actual real life time. You have that much time to use your survivalist move. So be mindful of that. So don't go around just, you know, screwing around in one time if you use a survivalist map, because then you'll just end up wasting the thing. Go ahead and just kill this guy. Boom! There we go. We saved the guys, brother. Okay. Let me go ahead and see if I can. There we go. We saved you.
Get the hell out of here.
At least you can do after trying to eat.
He's sure to get to safety. He's right there. So he should be fine. There you go. Now get out of here, guys.
I'm indebted to you, mister.
Okay, gave us seven shotgun ammo. It's not like that much, but hey, it's whatever. I think this is Hummingbird Sage still. Yeah. We need to look for Violet Snowdrop. That's what we need to look for. So, let's go ahead and get on the horse and let's go explore this area just a tiny bit here. We got the survivalist map on, so we should be able to see a lot of stuff. We might actually run into a bunch of animals here, too. That's actually one thing about tall trees. It's got a lot of animals. Sometimes, I swear to you guys, this has happened to me on multiple occasions. I've had upwards of 5 bears attack me at once. I crap you not, guys. Hummingbird Sage. That's not what we want. Okay. Is this it? That's Violet Snowdrop. There we go.
Might as well.
That's one. We need 4 more. But yeah, I swear to you guys, I have found at least like 5 bears attack me at once. It was not fun, and I'd rather not that repeat here. I tread lightly when I come to tall trees because of that reason. I kill one bear, another one spawns. I kill that bear, another one spawns. It's really not that fun, and honestly, I don't want that to happen here. I really hope it doesn't happen here. Okay, so we need 2 more of these. Let's see if this one's up here is a Violet Snowdrop. I think it is. Yep, another Violet Snowdrop right here. So we need 1 more. I think that's all. Yeah, collect 1 more Violet Snowdrop for West Dickens. Just really surprised he actually had us go up to tall trees to get this stuff. But, you know, He needs this ingredient, so. Yeah, that one should be it. I think this one's it. Oh, yep, that's it. There's the Violet Snowdrop I'm looking
for. That's one.
Okay, so we've got all our goods that we need. Now we need to go back to West Dickens and deliver the flowers, which I'm going to go ahead and do. So we're pretty far away from West Dickens. So we're going to go ahead and just, you know, go all the way out there. Actually, hold on a sec. Let's go ahead and mark that. I didn't really make a destination there. There we go. Alright, so with that, guys, I will see you guys when we get there. Alright, guys. You guys saw the little blip up right now. It said your survivalist map has been exhausted. That little blip tells you, saying, hey, you just used up all your survivalist map. Yeah, I've been riding around for 20 minutes. Going and doing all this crap. But that's a little message you get whenever it says that your map has been exhausted. We're actually almost back to Nigel West Dickens. That's what the best part is. I should have been using fast travel a lot better than I can. You can use fast travel at any safe zone that you unlock, but, eh. Uh-oh. We can actually help this guy real quick. I'm gonna go ahead and do that. I'm gonna save these guys. These guys are at the camp and need help, so we're gonna go ahead and make it a little bit easier for them. Go ahead and do that. If you manage to save them, they do give you ammo for it. I don't want to aim at that guy. Gosh, that guy's there. There's a zombie. There we go. The thing is about Deadeye, and I don't know if you guys noticed it or not, but if you do like a 360 degree turn or something, you will like kind of ruin your chances with Deadeye. So it's really not advised to do what I just did and just, you know, do a 360 degree turn, because you do kind of ruin some of the marks that you made. That zombie is not dying. Is he dead yet?
Hey, none of you touch me.
He's just wasting ammo on him. There we go. Now he's dead.
Thanks. We might head to Fort Mercer to hunker down.
Travel safely. And stay away from anyone groaning.
Shit!
Stay away from anyone groaning. Okay, so we got actually a lot of ammunition from that guy, from those guys, now that we helped him. That's another thing you can be doing. There's going to be guys, you know, hunkered down at a camp and need help because they're overrun by zombies. That's another thing you'll encounter.
Let's go!
Of the many things. So be mindful of that when you're looking around. I mean, you don't have to do them. It's just an easy way to get extra cash. Or not extra cash. Extra ammo and ammunition. But I think we're getting close to an area. There's Mr. Nigel West Dickens. So let's go ahead and see what's going on with him.
Another satisfied customer, Mr. West Dickens.
Oh, hello, John. Yeah, poor fellow can't get enough.
As I see.
Get rid of him, would you?
Why?
Well, because we're old friends.
No.
Because we'll team up and fight the forces of darkness together?
No.
Because I've got something you want. Trust me, you cynical bastard. Thank you, dear boy. Oh, thank you. Oh, did you get the stuff?
Of course.
Oh, excellent. Oh, wait just a minute. here you go. Now these should help. If I've got my mathematics correct, they'll blow the buggers apart.
And if you've got your sums wrong?
Oh, ye of little faith. Now listen, John. You're going to need some more serious weaponry. I've got a plan, but you need to pick up some old parts at Riley's Charge.
Another shopping trip.
Yeah, well, excuse me if my efforts in salvation are interrupting your busy social calendar, John. I'm only trying to help because
we're old friends. I know. You better not be wasting my time.
Me? Never. Perish the thought.
I've lost my damn mind. I hope.
Okay, so for doing that for Nigel West Dickens, he gave us phosphorus coating. Phosphorus coating is a treatment that modifies all ammo to set undead ablaze with blue fire. Open your satchel with the correct herbs in hand to coat your rounds. So this is what the flowers are used for in this DLC. It's used for the phosphorus coating. Phosphorus coating pretty much makes all the zombies turn, you know, a blaze of blue fire. And whatnot. But, anyways, we're actually going to go over here to Riley's charge right here. And you probably noticed that this symbol popped up on the screen right now. We're going to be doing that in the next episode. Don't worry about that for right now, because that's going to be an all-in-an-episode of itself right there. It's going to be called Missing Souls. We're going to be doing that later, so keep that in mind. But anyways, I'm going to go ahead and cut until we get to Riley's charge, so I'll see you guys in just a second. Alright guys, we're heading up here to Riley's charge. If we come up here, we'll find that thing that Nigel West Dickens wants us to do. We also got zombies wanting to kill us, so let's go over here to the W. Come over here, we search. And now we have to return the old parts to Nigel West Dickens. Yet another little fetch quest he's wanting us to do. How many fetch quests does this old man want us to do? I swear. It's like we're, you know, work for the darn guy. Anyways, I'll see you guys when we get back to the W, which is, again, all the way over here. Cure for what most ails you. Alright, guys. We're here near where Nigel West Dickens again is at. If you guys remember this spot, this is where, in the main game, where Seth had taken Moses and he beat the crap out of him to find the map. Find his map here at Benedict Point. This is where he did that in the main game. So if you want to know where we're at.
West Dickens! Nigel! Where are you, old man? You better not have gotten killed.
Under here!
Get out here.
Are you alone?
No. I brought the great mass hordes of the undead with me. Of course I'm alone.
Well, it's not the undead I'm worried about, dear boy. I kind of like them. It's the normal people I can't stand.
What's happened?
Now, don't be like that. I haven't done anything, or stolen anything, or even lied that much.
What then?
A bunch of people just chased me out of town. They blame me for everything that's happened. I tell you, John Marston, I've been selling health tonics for years from here to Timbuktu, and never once has there been a demonic bloodlust or the undead rising up. It's preposterous.
Okay.
No. They want to hang me. Me, an honest salesman. Can you believe that?
Snake oil merchant who cried wolf.
Well, yeah, something like that. Well, I'm headed south. I'm headed down to Mexico. I hear things are much better down there, not to mention the climate and the nice locals, but also the merciful lack of cannibalistic morons with infectious eye diseases. Oh, did you get the bits and bobs I requested?
Sure.
Ah, ha, ha, excellent. Just a moment. Okay. There. See. No. Ah! Here you go.
I risked my life for this? A blunderbuss? Is this a joke? What is this, 1850?
Oh, ye of such little faith. You've been hanging around cattle and killers too long. You've got the compassion of a mass murderer and the intellect of a cow patty.
I'll stick your faith in this gun where the sun don't shine.
This is the weapon of choice for demonic horde killers everywhere, from Romania to Edinburgh and all the other places the undead roam. You can put pretty much anything into it and blow a bunch of the buggers away in one go. Makes your rifle look like a pea shooter.
You better not be lying to me.
Would I lie to you, John? To others, I admit the occasional sin of omission. But to you, never, dear boy. Now, Now, I am headed down to Mexico. Is there any chance that I will see you there?
We shall see.
Well, if you're interested, I should be at Solomon's Folly in a few days, trying to figure out a way to get in. I hear the border is not as open as it used to be. Ta-ta!
Well, we got quite a bunch of stuff from Nigel West Dickens, and he's not lying. The blunderbuss is probably the best weapon in the game. Blunderbuss is an explosive weapon that can take on multiple undead at once. It uses undead body parts as ammunition. Ew. Let's go ahead and test it out on this guy. Look, watch this. That's what the blunderbuss does. Now, it says it may take some time for Nigel West Dickens to get to Mexico, so we'll have to come back to it at a later time. So you just have to let time pass for a little bit. This is actually kind of a great segue for the next episode, because next episode, I'm not going where Nigel West Dickens is. But as you guys see, that's what the blunderbuss does. It just pretty much... Look at it! There's nothing left to that guy! He just blew to smithereens! I guess I should go ahead and show off the phosphorus coating here. If we come over here to, I think it was... right here, yeah, in the kit. If you go to phosphorus coating, you look at your, look at the info, it says, creates and applies phosphorus coating to all bullets in a short time. Uses one sage of any variety and one violet snowdrop. Flowers can be found in tall trees, Rio Bravo, and Gaptooth Bridge. So, we're gonna go ahead and use this. There we go. Use it. Okay. So if we go ahead and come up and find a zombie here. Look at him. He turns blue. He's on fire. Keep it. This is a very... These are very good weapons that Nigel West Dickens actually gave us. So he was not lying to us for once. So that's actually really good. And it's really good against zombies. But if you go up to a zombie and you start, you know... searching their corpses and all that other jazz. Let me come over here to this one real quick. Have to burn the blue flame. Actually, it didn't really give me anything. If you start searching corpses for zombies, now you'll get undead body parts. You can use this to create ammunition for your blunderbuss. Your blunderbuss doesn't have very much ammo, which it rightfully ought not have it, because it is the strongest weapon in the game. But it's very limited ammo, and you have to actually look for the undead body parts as ammunition. But I think that's it. Anyways, guys, I think what I'm going to be doing is I'm going to end the episode here. So in the next episode of Let's Play Red Dead Redemption Undead Nightmare, we have pretty much done everything that we can do in New Austin, except for this right here. While we're waiting for Nigel West Dickens to get ready to go into Mexico, we're actually going to come here, back here to Fort Mercer and start this missing soul mission. And I'm going to tell you right now, it's a lot more than what you think it is. Missing souls is part of a bigger side quest for the 100% of this game. So with that, I'll see you guys next episode. Take care, everybody.